morning and welcome to our worship together. Today, I encourage you to stand as we worship the Lord together. Give thanks.
Give thanks to the Lord, our God and King. Love endures forever. For He is good, He is above all things. His love endures forever. Sing praise. Sing praise. With a mighty hand outstretched out, love endures forever. For the life that's been reborn, love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise,
sing praise,
sing praise, sing praise. Forever God is faithful. Forever God is strong. Forever God is with us. Forever. Forever.
From the rising?
From the rising to the setting sun, love endures forever. And by the grace of God, we will carry on. Love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise, sing praise, sing praise. Forever God is faithful. Forever God is strong. Forever God is with us. Forever,
one more time.
Forever you are faithful. Forever you are strong. Forever you are with us, Lord. Forever. Forever.
The truth of the life.
Father, as we come before you to worship you, we do this not because of anything we've done, but because of the love that you have for each and every one of us. And as we continue to explore what it means to be in that relationship with you and live out the plan that you have planned for us, Lord, let us learn it well in our hearts and our minds and through our ears, Lord. Bless our time together, and I pray all these things in your Son's most precious name. And all of God's people say, Amen. Good morning, kids. It's Pastor Stephen here, and welcome back to our second Sunday of June, where we are spending not 1 month, but 2 months on our theme, which is press play, get in the mix. Our passage from this month and next month is from Psalm chapter 27, verse 13, where it says this. I remain confident of this. I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Now, for those of you who was with us last month, you'll remember that our theme was about building our relationships and setting good foundation and routine and disciplines for us to grow with God. One of the things that I think should happen, and I think does happen, when we deepen our relationship with God is we get a better perspective, a better idea of what God thinks about us, and more importantly, what God has planned for us. You see, sometimes our plans and God's plans, they're close, they're similar, and sometimes they're like this, completely far apart, and sometimes they're like this. Half of it's the same, half of it, just as important, is not the same. Many, many years ago, only too many, so not that long ago, when I was going into university, I had already recognized that God had given me a passion to work with kids, kids like you. But I thought, in my plan, that God wanted me to be a psychologist, a child psychologist, that I would work with kids, especially kids who had what we're going to call difficulties with school or difficulties with their family. Of course, as you can tell, that's clearly not what happened. I did not become a child psychologist. Instead, even though some of my plan was the same, God's plan for me was very different. And here I am today, a children's pastor. Today in our story out of Joshua, we have an interesting situation, I think, where God's plan for them is completely different than what they would expect it to be. Check this video out.
The Bible, it's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how He created us and loves us so much that He made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Joshua, chapters 5 and 6.
For 40 years, God's people wandered the desert. At last, they reached the land that God had promised them. Joshua led them to the edge of the rushing Jordan River.
The priests will carry the Ark of the Lord.
The Ark was a beautiful chest that reminded the Israelites that God was with them.
As soon as the priests step into the Jordan, it will stop flowing.
Sure enough, as soon as the foot of the first priest touched the edge of the river, the waters parted. God's people crossed on dry land, just as God had led them through the Red Sea 40 years before.
God did this so that all the nations on earth would know that He is powerful.
Soon after, the Amorites and Canaanites living in the land had heard what God had done. Fearful, they retreated back to their towns, including the high-walled city of Jericho.
Oh, great. Like, how do we fight them now?
God will show us the way.
That evening, Joshua left camp and snuck toward Jericho. The walls loomed impossibly strong.
so tall.
As he turned, Joshua saw a man standing nearby holding a sword.
Who are you? Are you on our side or the side of our enemies?
I have come as the commander of the Lord's army.
Joshua knelt down, face to the ground.
What message does my Lord have for me?
Take off your sandals. The place you are on is holy ground.
Joshua tugged off his shoes.
I have handed Jericho over to you.
Joshua listened carefully as the Lord delivered a message, a battle plan unlike any other.
Wow. Okay, we'll do it, Lord.
Joshua called for the priests.
Get the Ark of the Covenant, and I need 7 of you to march in front of the Ark with trumpets.
Sorry, just warming up.
Joshua gathered the army too.
Time to move out.
Like, do we get to attack now?
March around the city.
Just, like, go in circles?
Some of you march ahead of the Ark of the Lord, and the rest of you march behind.
Can we at least shout and stuff? Hey, Jericho, you guys smell like cheese!
Don't give a war cry or raise your voices until the day I tell you to shout. But the priests must blow their trumpets. Forward! March!
The entire army, including the priests, marched one time around Jericho, just as the Lord had instructed Joshua.
Now can we get them?
Back to camp, men. We march again tomorrow.
The next morning, the Israelites marched around the city once again. And then on day 3, once again on day 4, not to mention day 5, and once again on day 6.
We march again at sunrise.
I have blisters.
At dawn on the 7th day, the army and priests formed their strange parade once more. But this time, once they finished marching around the city one time, Joshua called out.
Keep marching.
Again? My feet are killing me.
The Lord has told me we must march around the city 7 times today.
On the 7th time around, the priests blew a long blast on their trumpets.
Now shout! The Lord has given you the city!
And the oh, yeah, you're smelling cheese!
As the shouts of the Israelites rang out in the clear morning air, something incredible happened. The massive walls of Jericho began to tremble. The gates shivered and quaked. Jagged cracks ran through the heavy stones. Rocks began to tumble from the tops of the walls. Little rocks, large stones, giant boulders. Until at last, the walls collapsed, crashing in on themselves. The ground quaked, and plumes of dust burst into the air. As the air cleared, the Israelites stared in amazement. The city of Jericho stood wide open.
Take the city!
With nothing standing in their way, the Israelites charged right in. That day, they completely defeated the city of Jericho. God was with Joshua, and he became well known everywhere in the land.
You guys watch that video? Isn't that crazy? They didn't fight anyone, but what they did was they obeyed God and they followed God's plan, and everything turned out the best for them. I think the Israelites learned this from their experience, and perhaps they've already learned this before, but God's plan is the best plan. Now, you're young, and you might say to Pastor Stephen, say to me, I'm so young. I don't know God's plan for me. I don't know what he wants me to be when I grow up. I don't know what I'm supposed to do when I turn 100 years old. Well, that's okay. As we mentioned earlier, understanding God's plan works alongside with us getting to know God better. The more we get to know God better, the more we know his plans. The more we know his plans, the more we deepen our understanding of God. So there's 2 things that I think will help you be ready when God shows you his plans, if he's not already doing that. First one, somewhat from last month, is to continue to study your Bible and continue your prayer. That's a discipline that we need to be doing regularly. And in many ways, some of God's plan is revealed to us through his word and through our time in prayer. So remember to continually, diligently study the word and to pray regularly. But God doesn't just reveal his plans through scripture and through when you pray to him and when you talk to him. He also reveals his plan to the people that are around you. Sometimes it's your parents, sometimes it's your pastors, sometimes it's your elders. Now, if you remember at the very beginning of our time together, I mentioned that God didn't let me be a child psychologist, but he led me to become a children's pastor. That was his plan. Well, for me to see that plan, yes, there was studying his word, yes, there was time of prayer, but there are also a lot of conversations where godly people like my parents or like my pastors, they also confirm some of the things I was seeing, that God was indeed calling me into becoming a pastor. Listen to your parents, listen to your pastors, and listen to your elders, especially when God has placed something on their hearts to tell you about God's plan for you. God's plan is the best plan. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we don't know your plans for us, whether it's tomorrow, next week, next month, next year, or maybe 50 years from now. And just like we don't know what our plans are for tomorrow, or even 30 minutes from watching this video, Lord, we know that you are the one who rules in each and every one of our lives, and you have the greatest plan for us, whether it's what we're going to eat today, or where we're going to live in 50 years. As we grow with you, Lord, and as we build our confidence on you and on you alone, let us remember to trust in the plans that you have for us when they make sense and sometimes when they don't. Be with us, Lord, this week, and I pray all these things in your son's most precious name. And all of God's people say, amen. Hey, everyone, just one announcement today. This Saturday, June the 19th, is again going to be our monthly family prayer night. So remember to come with your family, your siblings, whether they're older than you or even the youngest of your siblings. And we're going to have a great time praying together for one another. Whether you're sitting or standing, let us receive today's benediction from 2 Thessalonians chapter 3, verse 16. Now may the Lord of peace himself give you peace at all times and in every way. The Lord be with all of you. We'll see you next week.